Well, Donald Trump's former national security advisor has lashed out at the Republican Party, accusing it of coddling Trump while he trashes the US electoral system.
The man himself, John Bolton, joins us now from Washington, D.C. John, great to see you again. This election was called 5 days ago. How much longer is it going to take for the president to accept the loss?
Well, I don't know that he's ever going to accept the loss. And really, what I'm trying to say is not to be critical of the Republican Party, but to get the party to say Donald Trump's interests are not the same as ours. Donald Trump is advancing his interest. We need to advance the country and the party's interest.
Has he provided any valid legal arguments or persuasive evidence yet of this election fraud?
Well, no, he hasn't. And I think that's important. So for all the people who say, you know, the president has a right to make these claims and under the various state laws, yeah, that's true. I don't think anybody can dispute that. But really, that's beside the point. We're at the stage, really past the time, when we need to see the evidence of these claims of fraud. And it has not materialized in cases in several different states. Several have been thrown out of court by the trial judges already. The others that I've looked at don't have any more substance to them. So really, people are going to need to understand the claims are frivolous. And that's why Republican leaders, I think, have to stand up and tell the people the truth. It's not going to come from Donald Trump. It has to come from other responsible leaders.
And, John, that's a difficult thing, is it not, because of his popularity? And given that he got 73 million votes, it's hard for someone inside that party, like, for example, maybe a Mike Pence, to go, Don, it's time you moved off, when that risks alienating the very people who voted for the party in the first place.
Yeah. Well, remember, of course, a lot of people voted against the left wing of the Democratic Party, too. And we had enormous success exceeding the president's success in Senate races, in House of Representatives races, in state races. So it's the question here is whether we will be tarred with the campaign that the president's really waging, I'm sad to say, against the electoral system of the country as a whole. If he's got evidence of election wrongdoing, we need to see it. And we just can't depend on his word for it. It has to stand up in court. So far, there isn't anything that meets that standard.
The issue you've got is these 70 million plus voters, they're never going to accept a new president because Trump has made them believe that the election is a fraud.
Well, if I may respectfully disagree there, that's where the Republican leadership is important, to explain to people what the truth is. And I don't think the Republican Party is afraid of its own base. If we've come to that point, we're in very difficult shape. But I don't think we're there. I just think if people are not giving the voters the alternative, which happens to comport with the truth in this case, it will be much harder for them to accept defeat. So there's an obligation to the country, not just the party, to be straightforward here and to tell them what's going on. I think that's critical. I'll just give you a hard political judgment here. That's critical to future success for the Republican Party. It also is very important for the future of the country that people have trust in the electoral system.
John, it's so good to talk to you. I'm such an intelligent voice, and we appreciate you coming on our show. Anytime you're here, and I'm sure it's going to be soon again. Thank you, John. We're coming up.